Welcome to Lunar Astro. So this is the first video I'm doing in terms of a series. This is a complete series which I'm going to do. It's a very basic series. And the reason why I'm doing the basic series is because all the stunning predictions which you have seen, it required a very basic knowledge. Your basics are good. You know what the strength of the chart is, where to actually look at. You see, a few days back, I was doing a reading for a lady, 40 years old. And I looked at the chart and I made a prediction that this year, you have to take a major decision of the life. And the decision is, choose between husband or money. You have to make a choice. This is the year. Why this? How does this? This is a story of her life in one line. She said, and after that, she explained me the situations she is going through. And see, life is not on black and white. And that's how the life is designed. It's a complicated situation. But yes, this is the test she has to go through. Past life, she must have failed on the same test. That's why in this life, same test is coming up. Next life, if she failed again, this particular life, same test will come up. Choose between money or husband. After that, I did the consultation. Now other prediction is required, because when you hit the core of the chart now, you don't require anything else. I mean, there will be clients, like you can tell them the greatest prediction ever in the chart. Prediction like four years before your birth, your father had a fight with a priest. This is a prediction. That is why you have a problem right now. This is a prediction. And still the people will ask, leave it, sir. If my father has fight with someone, that's fine. I know about this. They accuse someone of stealing money. They fought with him. They accused a Brahmin who came to their house for doing puja, and they fought with him. He confirmed it. It happened. A very big incident. He said, but leave it. What it has to do with me? Just tell me how I will get the money. See, some people will not deserve the predictions. But that's the story of life. When to pinpoint that one particular event in the chart, one particular event, a lot of hard work is required, and hard work starts from basics, where to actually look at. So I'm going to give you the technique today, one technique. I'm going to give you half technique. Rest half, if you work hard, you will get it. You have to work on at least 50 charts. Then you see how the life, whether you can pinpoint in that particular area or not. That you can tell the story of life in one line. Like there was a Delhi-based guy, very big. I was doing predictions for her, for him. Okay, predictions, right? This year wife, this year business. Last year, the prediction. This is a prediction, right? That last year your employee came back. The old employee must have came back and must have given you losses. And I said, yes, a very big loss happened. Still not convinced. Still not enjoying the reading. Then I made a prediction that you're very close to achieve spirituality. Very close. Then a lady came and you fall from that place. This is the prediction. And he said, what you have said is absolutely true. Has happened with me. This is a prediction. But to get to this prediction, you need to concentrate on certain things in chart. I'm going to start with a very basic step today. A very basic step is Bhavabal. You see, whenever Bhavabala is a composition of three things: the strength of the Lord, the strength of the house, how many plants are aspecting it, good or bad, doesn't matter, and the Rigbal. When these three things match up, these things add up, the Bhavabala is formed. So the house which gains excessive strength and excessive lower strength, these houses deserve to be seen. These houses need to be seen and require special attention. So all the yogas formed in these particular houses, we need to have a look. So let me share my PowerPoint with you. Okay. Bhavabal, the strength of the house. See, every house has a strength, and house deliver the results according to the strength only. So the strength of the house, what Varahamihiri said, should be 480 or more for a Rajyug. Then only the Rajyug will give the complete result. Ordinary house strength should be around 420. Any house going too low or too high of a strength requires attention. Suppose a house goes to strength of 150, it definitely requires your attention. And any house which goes above 480 requires your attention. Usually for the pinpointing a very particular, the purpose of the life, always look at the highest strength of the house. You should be able to see the major pattern of life through Bhavabal only. For example, looking at someone's hard work and gain and expenses, look at the 10th, 11th, 12th. Like how much, whether his job is completely is a regular job or a freelancer, the 10th house strength will tell you. Suppose 10th house has a strength of 300 something and 11th house has a strength of 800 something. This means this person is a freelancer. Will not work regularly, but will give the income regularly or will earn very high amount in very short span of time. Look at the second house as well, because second house is your earning capacity. Similarly, the 12th house are your expenses. A lot of other things as well, but I'm talking in terms of finance right now. To compare the married life, compare the strength of the first and the seventh house. Similarly, other matters can be seen through Bhavabal only. You can use it. When you will use it on several charts which you know, you'll find a lot of things through Bhavabal only. Okay, this is the first example. This is a chart of Arnold Schwarzenegger. You can see the first house has a strength of 728. And all his life, he's known for his body, first house, self, personality. Secondly, look at the lowest strength. Lowest strength is in the 8th house, 347. Now, this is a technique which I'm giving you. Look at the 8th Lord, where it is going. 8th Lord is going in 2nd house of family with 5th Lord conjuncted with the 5th Lord and Sun. Now, what if you know, Arnold Schwarzenegger had an illegal affair and was with the servant, the maid, and there was a son of him as well, illegal son. 5th and 8th connection gave him that. If you notice the dasha periods when this particular things operate, you will find the dasha's pattern will match out. So you can see, I've shown you how to use the yogas as well. But today I'm not going into yoga part, how to make yogas or how to see the yogas. Today where I'm going is only to tell you where to actually concentrate in a particular chart. Example number two. Of late Shri B.V. Raman Sahab. B.V. Raman Sahab was a great astrologer. But why he gained prominence was, he gained prominence because he predicted world war. His highest strength is in the 6th house of calamities. Look in the 6th house, 603 points. Look at 6th house, 603 points. And that's where he gained prominence in predicting the 6th house matters. You can look at the yogas later on. If you know how to make yogas, go ahead, delineate the charts which you know, and see how the yoga is playing up, which dasha is actually giving the results. You should follow the Laghu Parashari to see all these things, which dasha will give the which particular result. Example number 3 is of Donald Trump. The first house has the maximum strength. The sign rising is there, Leo. And then you can make the combinations. Leo going into 10th house. Why he became famous. What he has done in his whole life. You see the life pattern. The lower strength is in 7th house. You all know. 3 marriages. And kind of relationship he has with women. That's actually the problem area. Now, I'm going to share the another chart which I told you, the prediction which I did for the lady this year. Choose between husband or money. This is a chart. First house, maximum strength. Second, 638 in the 10th house. First house and 10th house has the maximum strength. Now, the lord of these two houses goes in the second house, conjuncted with the Venus and Moon. I look at all the other factors, look at the dashas, look, use several other techniques, made this prediction. But this, what I'm trying to say is, Bhavabal is the first thing you need to see in any chart. To make sure you have the right idea. Now, different softwares calculate it very differently. There will be difference in color, will be different, in Jehora it will be different, in Parashralite it will be different. It doesn't matter. What you can do is, you can either calculate it yourself, order a book online of Grahan Bhavabal by B.B. Raman sir. There are several others as well. Or you can just take a ballpark figure. That will do. I trust in ballpark figures. Plus minus 20 points, it doesn't matter much. The another thing is, when you buy books, please buy from the saptarishishop.com, because their website, what happens when you buy books, the money which is going for the books, first of all, there's always a scheme that if you buy for like 500 rupees or 700 rupees, I think, you get an extra book free. Secondly, the money which is going to Saptarishi is getting utilized in the Jyotish only. They're working for Jyotish so much. So you should buy from them only. And the main thing is, there's Astro Darbar coming up. So what you should do is, subscribe to Astro Darbar. It's very cheap. They're very nominal. They have kept it for a whole year. The subscription is for 5,000 rupees. And what they're doing is, they're bringing all the complete pool of astrologers. I mean, the first lecture itself is going to be so great. I mean, that lecture could have cost 5,000 rupees. Astagvarga. And you should go and subscribe to that one. And see. Because astrology is based on thought processes. Unless you have a good thought to see how the technique is, particular technique is working. Like what I've given you, a thought. It's up to you how you're going to work on it. So this thought process should not be stopped. If you have good players with you, if you have good thoughts with you, the energy of the other astrologers, you can be a good astrologer. If it's missing, you will lack out. It is very simple. For that thought generation process, subscribe to Saptarishi Astrology Astro Darbar. So you're like, there's a technique of Ketu. Ketu, wherever it sits, it divides. This is from Astro Darbar. Ketu, wherever it will sit, it will divide. This is a technique from Astro Darbar. It never fails. I use it every single day in my predictions. So subscribe to this one and subscribe to my channel as well. I will keep coming up with the next building block. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to streamline the process for you. A lot of people out there I know have more knowledge than me. I know this because I talk to a lot of you. You know every single detail, every single technique, from Varshfal, I mean, you know, Western astrology, Bhrigu astrology, Nadi astrology, Hora Shastra, Gemini, everything you guys know. But when it comes to predictions, there is no prediction. What I'm going to do, I'm going to streamline that process. So this is the first thing I would like you to do. Look at the Bhava balloon. Look at 50 charts of people you know. See how does that particular area, which in somebody suffering in marriage, look at the seventh house, seventh lord, where it is sitting. What is actually happening? Sometimes the house with the highest Bhava bal is the problem area. Why? Because might be all the malefics are expecting it. Malefics will kill the living beings. It's a rule of Eskimeta Sab. Malefics will kill all the living beings, but it will increase the non-living things. Like business will increase, but there will be no marriage. Or second house, all the malefics, lot of money, no family. This is how it works. And benefics, what they will do, they will kill all the non-living things, increase the living things. All the people in that house. It's a very wonderful rule you should work out. And you should subscribe to this channel. And next video, what I'm going to do, I'm going to show you how to make particular yogas. Like today I showed you a glimpse of it. Like fifth and eighth connection, illegal affairs, illegal child. Fifth and eighth is also the combination for astrologers as well. Fifth and eighth means a lot of things, but how to interpret it, whether it's going to be a neighbor or a sibling, how to differentiate it. I will show you how to do that. How to make predictions like this. Okay, so see you next time.